Je voudrais commencer aujourd'hui avec quelques mots sur
I'd like to begin today with a few words on the news concerning the Governor General of Canada, Julie Payette. Everyone deserves to have a safe and secure workplace, including those who work on the Governor General's team. This is something I take very seriously. Yesterday, I accepted the resignation of Ms. Payette. This morning, I spoke on the phone with Her Majesty the Queen, and I informed her that the Chief Justice of Canada will fulfill the duties of the Governor General on a temporary basis. A recommendation concerning the...
For all high-level appointments, there is a rigorous vetting process that was followed in this case. Obviously, we will continue to look at that vetting process to ensure that it is the best possible process as we move forward. Obviously, the vetting process that was in place was followed, but obviously we're going to also look at ways we can strengthen and improve the vetting process for high-level appointments.
To be the Governor General. Answer, I think that Ms. Payette, with her emphasis on science and service, brought a great deal of positive aspects to her, to the job. Obviously, everyone has the right to enjoy a safe and secure workplace. This is something that our government profoundly believes in. And for this reason, we accepted the Governor General's resignation. Follow-up question. Mr. Trudeau, you spoke with Ms. Payette Wednesday night on the phone. What did you say? Did you try to encourage her to resign? Answer, I had the chance to sit down in person with Ms. Payette to speak about the situation. She explained that for the good of the institution and the country, she would submit her resignation, and I accepted it.
You did not use a committee like the past government to select Madame Payette as Governor General. You went with your own personal selection, and the vetting process couldn't have been that rigorous because it was pretty easy for me to find out that she left two past workplaces amid controversy and questions around her treatment of staff there. So why didn't your government ask some pretty basic questions about her ability to lead, and why won't you commit to using a committee to select the next Governor General?
As I said, we are looking right now at processes that can be strengthened as we move forward, and we will have more to say on that as we make decisions.
But why not use a committee? Obviously, they did not work the first time.
We will continue to look at the best way to select people for the vice-regal appointments. It's an important role for Canadians, and we will look at how we can improve it.
Nous allons toujours regarder comment nous pouvons améliorer
we
le processus de vérification et de sélection
for the position of Governor
General. Prime Minister Tonda McCharles, Toronto Star. A lot of observers look at this and believe that you bear a lot of responsibility for your choice. I'd like to know, do you owe an apology to the workers at Rideau Hall, past and present, who suffered in that workplace? Do you owe an apology to them? Do you owe an apology to Canadians?
I think as a government, we've demonstrated time and time again how important it is to create workplaces that are free and safe from harassment and in which people can do their important jobs in safety and security. That is why we moved forward on significant measures for Parliament, for the public service, and why we consider that we needed to accept the resignation of Julie Payette, given the concerns that were raised. Obviously, the work that has been done by people working at Rideau Hall over the past years has always been exceptional. They fulfill important duties for Canadians, and as we saw, were sometimes in very difficult situations. We want to thank them for their work and reassure them that we will continue to stand up for workplaces that are safe and secure everywhere in the government, but indeed across the country.